What's up, guys? Aaron J. Daigle here to talk about World War Me, the war on the inside, the one I fight every day, but that you never see. It's the struggle I deal with inside of my own mind. I'm talking about the desire to live a life pleasing to God that constantly fights against the desire to live one pleasing to me. It's the man behind the mask, the face beyond the facade. It's the battle that tells me I'm a failure because I failed to fulfill the goals I set down. World War Me is the tears I cry after messing up. It's the battle to do the right thing, but inevitably doing the wrong thing. And we see World War Me in Galatians 5:17, which tells us that the sinful nature wants to do evil, which is just the opposite of what the Spirit wants. And the Spirit gives us desires that are the opposite of what the sinful nature desires. These two forces are constantly fighting each other, so you are not free to carry out your good intentions. You see, World War Me is saying I'm going to read the Bible and pray, but then getting up and starting my day instead. It's the decision to quit smoking, but buying another pack on the way home. It's me saying I'll fast once a week, but eating a Big Mac instead. It's World War Me. It's the desire to do ministry, but then not doing what I committed to do. It's the commitment to never sin that way again, yet finding myself entangled in the same stuff. And it's the decision to smash the like button for the YouTube algorithm, but not smashing it, thereby not helping Aaron grow the channel. It's World War Me. And not only do I struggle with World War Me, but somebody in the Bible struggled with it also. He was a great apostle. He wrote at least 12 books in the New Testament, went on 3 missionary trips, preached and pastored, taught and triumphed. His name was Paul, and God even did unusual miracles through his ministry. Yet at the same time, he was no stranger to World War Me. In fact, Paul even said about himself in the Bible that the things I don't want to do are the things I do, and the things I want to do, I can't bring myself to actually do them. I've lived through World War Me, Paul lived through World War Me, and if you've been alive longer than 17.3 seconds, then you've also lived through World War Me. So what do you mean, Aaron, that both you and me live through World War Me? What I mean is that we both want to do right, but we often just don't seem to do it. In fact, we keep doing the exact things we don't want to do. We drink after promising God and our families will never drink again. We worry after already giving the situation to God in prayer. Go back to the same abusive boyfriend, look at porn after trying to escape it, decide to quit but get high again, and even promise the zookeeper not to feed the animals, but give ice cream to the giraffes as soon as he turns around. And you know why we do these things? Because we're in World War Me. You know what World War Me makes us think about ourselves? We feel sick about who we are. My family doesn't want anything to do with me. My friends don't want anything to do with me. And in World War Me, we can actually come to a place where we start feeling like even God doesn't want anything to do with me. And that's why I want to show you how Jesus actually responds to someone in World War Me. You see, when Paul found himself in this struggle in Romans 7 and said, I can't do what I want to do, and the things I don't want to do, I keep doing them, he concluded with a question. Who will help me from World War Me? Then he answers the question for us himself in Romans 7:25 and says, I thank God. It's through Jesus Christ, our Lord. You see, Jesus himself is our way out of World War Me. That's what Hebrews 4:15 means when it says, we do not have a high priest who cannot sympathize with our weaknesses, but was in all points tempted as we are, yet without sin. Do you know what it's like to be tempted? So does Jesus. Do you know what it's like to question your identity? So does Jesus. Do you know what it's like to feel isolated from God and condemned because of sin? Well, remember when he was on the cross and said, Father, Father, why have you forsaken me? So does Jesus. He knows where you are, he knows what you're struggling with, and he sees the World War Me inside of you. And Jesus cares about the issues that World War Me has created inside of your life, because he has a tendency to be attracted to people with needs. That's why Luke chapter 8 tells the story of the woman with an issue of blood. It said that for 12 years she had this issue. She went to doctor after doctor, spent all the money that she had to get healed, and couldn't find a way out of her situation. But Jesus was passing through the crowd, and she said to herself, if I can just touch his clothes, I'll be healed. And she reaches out and grabs a part of his clothing, and immediately healing went out from Jesus' body into her body and healed her of her issue. Now, what I'd like to point out from this story is that the Bible says that this woman had an issue. And that's important to notice because World War Me has probably created some issues in your life. But the Bible says that Jesus healed that woman of her issue. So what's your issue? Is it your children? Your finances? Maybe it's a drug issue, a drink issue, or a job issue. Perhaps there's an issue in your marriage or an issue with a sin. World War Me could have left you with a guilt issue or a regret issue. And if you're like me, we have the issue of trying to open the door sideways instead of upwards on our brand new Lamborghinis. I'm just kidding, I drive a Honda Accord, but still. If World War Me has caused you an issue, then God wants to show you that He healed the woman of her issue. And that He'll do the same for you that He did for someone else. But Aaron, what if my issue ain't some random thing? Like, I've been dealing with this for a long time. I've tried to quit for years, but can't seem to do it. I've made the same New Year's resolution for a decade, but I know it'll probably be back on the list again next January. I promised my spouse and my children that I'd do X, Y, and Z, but still haven't even kept promises A and B. I've always been this way, and I can't seem to change. That's why the Bible points out that she had her issue for 12 years. She wrestled with her issue for over a decade, and you may have been dealing with this for 12 days, 12 months, or 12 years. But the Bible shows us that when the woman with an issue touched Jesus's clothes, she was instantly healed. Now that's Jesus's part to do the healing. Our responsibility is to touch Him. But what exactly does this mean? Well, Hebrews chapter 12, verses 1 and 2 gives us some understanding about this. It says, "Let us strip off every weight that slows us down, especially the sin that so easily trips us up, and let us run with endurance the race God has set before us." We do this by keeping our eyes on Jesus, the champion who initiates and perfects our faith. You see, our natural tendency when dealing with World War Me is to look inside of ourselves and try to figure it out. But the more we try to analyze, pick it apart, dig it up, and make sense of it all, the further down the rabbit hole of guilt and confusion we find ourselves in. So when it says that we keep our eyes on Jesus, we do that by looking away from World War Me onto the champion who perfects our faith. We focus on the cross of Christ. Instead of looking at our sin, we look at His salvation. Instead of focusing on the sickness, we fixate on His healing. Instead of trying to change our loved ones, we allow Him to change us through His word and by the fruit of His spirit. This is why when Paul asked, "Who will save me from World War Me?" He didn't say Paul. He said, "I thank God it's through Jesus Christ our Lord." Jesus will get right into World War Me alongside of you and help you through your issues. So thank you so much for watching. If you could help out with the channel and like this video if you haven't liked it already, I'd appreciate it so much. Also subscribe and turn on the notifications bell to stay updated with the newest videos. In the meantime, if you'd like more from me before I post the next one, then I'll link the books I've published down in the description below. You can click the link and check out what's available. And one last thing before you go, if you've been encouraged by this video, let's share it on social media and even share it directly with a personal friend. Let them know you saw this, thought of them, and wanted to use it to encourage them. And as always, guys, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.